Lovelies, it's a girl L here. I miss you guys so much. Sorry that I haven't been making any tutorials or any videos for you guys, but here is a treat for you. I'll be doing a twist out tutorial for you lovelies today. So I'm recording at night time and sorry about the lighting. But yeah, as you can see, my hair is in a mohawk hairstyle and I'm just taking out some hairpins out of my hair. I put loads. I don't know about you guys, but I use loads of bobby pins in my hair. And yeah, I'm just taking them out at the moment. You can see my hair has grown so much. It's so thick as well. As you can see, I'm getting exhausted. Ugh, there's so many bobby pins. But yeah, I'm just having a little scratch there. So yeah, after I take out my bobby pins, I like to massage my scalp because they hurt sometimes. So it's nice to do a bit of massage technique there. It'd be nice if someone did it for me, but you know. So I'm just putting a towel around my shoulder. Oh, yeah. And then I'm spraying it with some water. So I'm saturating my hair with some water. So I prefer to do the twist out on wet hair because my curls come out more defined. So yeah, that you can do it on dry or wet hair. I choose to do it on wet hair. So now I'm just sectioning my hair, and yeah, I'm just yeah parting that with the comb. So yeah, I just do a small section, not too big, because my hair is still short. So the ends doesn't. If I do it too big, the ends won't hold. So I do it kind of small. As my hair get longer, I will do large twist out to get bigger waves. But now I have to do them really small. And yeah, I'm sure you guys know how to twist. So you just divide the hair into two and just, yeah, just do a rope twist. And I have to kind of twist the ends round and round and round because else it will unravel. So I have to pay extra attention to the ends. Yeah, so that's what I do. Can see those are my two twists, and yeah, I'm gonna be doing the rest of my hair like this, so I'll get back to you when I reach the top. So now I've reached the top of my hair, so it all depends what you like. You can do side parting or middle parting. I choose to do side for my twist out. Oh, as you can see, I'm getting exhausted. So I just have a small section at the front, so I'm gonna kind of fast forward this bit for you guys, but yeah, I use a some clips to section off my hair so I don't get like any hair caught up in the twists. Yeah, get them all mixed up. So I use some sectioning clips for my hair. So yeah, this bit I'm just gonna fast forward this bit and add some music for you guys to enjoy. So
you make me stronger. Oh, Lord, you make me stronger.
Gracias, Jesús.
Watch me. From Jamaica to the Caribbean. Creator, Lord, you know my times. Seasons of
I've got one last twist to do on my days, but it took me about, I don't know, maybe 20 minutes, half an hour, depend. I was going quite fast, so about 20 minutes, I'll say, 20 minutes to half an hour. And here is a up close my twist. You can see like my ends, they still need to grow out some more, but yeah, they're catching up, they're growing. My hair's growing quite well, so I'm happy with the progress so far. But yeah, I just like to kind of go over some of them to make the ends curl. If you can, you can use like flexi rods or perm rods. I'm actually getting some perm rods soon, so I'll be using those on my hair ends so that I get more define curls at the end, but some of my hair do curl, some part do curl, then some, as you can see there, those at the side, they curl up. Isn't that cute? Aww, the baby curls. Yeah, so that's my twist. I can't wait to rot this when my hair gets a little bit longer to use as a protective hairstyle. But yeah, little shake there and crazy eye. Now, yeah, so I use a satin scarf or a bonnet, but this time I choose to use a satin scarf because it will lay the curls, the twist out, and they won't be used, like, all over the place in the morning. So, yeah, I use a satin scarf, and I tie that really well. You know, I wrap it round my head and look like a granny for bed. But, yeah, this is what I do at night time. And here comes the fake yarn. And I'll see you guys in the morning. Bye! So, good morning, lovelies. Now, I'm using some olive oil. This helps to combat any frizz. I don't want too much frizz. So, I'm just using some olive oil and, to give my hair some shine. So, that's all over my hand and my fingertips. And I'm just taking my time, well, sort of, and unraveling my twist. So, I don't know if I do it up close, but I don't start from the ends, because when you start from the ends, that's when you tend to get a lot of frizz at the end. So what I do, I start unraveling from the like middle of the each twist. Oh, here we go. So as you can see that I kind of twist going to the opposite side, and I just take them apart from the middle. As you can see, I don't start from the ends, and see, I have some nice defined curls going on there. And yeah, and just continue to do this throughout my whole head, and you know, just take your time, they come out quite easily. Then I'm gonna be using a afro pick, using a pick to just uplift my roots to give it a more bigger look. I've done a twist out and before, but I prefer the one before this one. But I'm quite happy with the curls in this video. But yeah, you can see my edges need laying down. I look a bit bold there. So I'm going to be using some Eco Styler gel. I use the Aragon one, and I'm just dabbing a small amount of gel on my edges. And then I use my bristle brush. I absolutely love this brush. I use this brush to lay my edges down. You can see. Ooh. And yeah, some baby hair. I like to do some baby hair. I love my baby hairs. This is the end result. I hope you guys enjoy, and I'll see you guys soon. Love you. Bye.